Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking today about descriptive statistics and, in particular, measures of variation. The measures of variation help us understand the spread of the data or how varied our data values are. So if you look at the image here to the right, data set A has less spread than data set B. You can see that the green set of data here, all the values are pretty much bunched together. But when you look at B, those data values are much more spread, kind of lending us that nice kind of small mound. And if you think about this as data sets, you might think about set A could represent the ages of all the students at a middle school. And that wouldn't range that much, maybe 3 or 4 years at the most. While set B could represent all the children at a park. And maybe there could be kids there that are 2 years old and somebody that's 14 or 15 years old. So those ages would range more and we'd see more spread in our data. One of the measures of variation that we look at is range. And that's the difference between the maximum and minimum values. So you're just taking the subtraction, max minus min. But the range is very sensitive to extreme values. And so we don't use it as often as other measures. And that means that the range is not resistant. When we say not resistant, we're saying it doesn't resist those outlier values. So if you think about that last example, maybe somebody was at the park that had a three-year-old playing and they had a six-month-old child just sitting in a car seat. And somebody else was 18, could be considered a child, but was there actually babysitting their 12-year-old sibling. And if we looked at those two extreme values, a six-month-old and an 18-year-old, it looks like the range is really big. But maybe everybody else that's actually playing at the park is between the ages of 2 and 12, and so that range wouldn't be as great. So those outliers can really have a big effect. And then the next one is standard deviation. We're going to spend some time talking about standard deviation because it's an important concept. The standard deviation of a set of sample values is denoted by S. If we're looking at a population, it's denoted by lowercase sigma. And it talks about the measure of the values about the mean. So we start with the mean and we say, well, what's the spread of the data from the mean out? And we start talking about standard deviation. The formulas that you see down here are very similar. The only difference is we have a lowercase n minus 1, n being the number of data values in a sample. And over here we have a capital N instead of an n minus 1, and that capital N is the data values in a population. And then that capital sigma means the summation of, so we would take every single data point, subtract the mean, and then square that. And then we would add all those data, those squares together, and then divide by n minus 1, and then take the square root of all of that to get the standard deviation. Now, it used to be people had to do that by hand and might have 12 different values, and they had to do this calculation for all 12 to get that sum. But I'm wanting you to use your calculator or StatCrunch or Excel if you know how to use that, but use something so that you're not spending your time calculating that. Some properties about the standard deviation that I want to talk about. It's a measure of variation of all the values from the mean. The standard deviation is positive. We say it's one standard deviation away. It could mean it's one to the left or one to the right. The value of the standard deviation can increase dramatically with the inclusion of outliers, and that means that it's not resistant either. So putting an outlier in there can really change the value. Values close together have a small standard deviation, and values with more variation have a large standard deviation. The units of standard deviation are the same as the original data values that you were given, and you should not be comparing standard deviation for two different data sets unless they use the same scale and units and they have means that are approximately the same. So in other words, we can't just compare standard deviations for things that are just totally different. When I'm looking at this picture here, that what I'm saying is the mean value is in the middle. This is a normal distribution, so it's normally distributed mean. We have a nice bell-shaped curve, it's symmetric. We have a mean and then one standard deviation out. is where this one, what that one means, and two standard deviations out is what the second one means. So maybe we could say that our mean is talking about the average height of a man in the United States. And let's say that that's 5'10". Then we say we have a standard deviation of 2". That means if this is 5'10", then one standard deviation away to the right means that that's 2 inches taller, or 6 foot tall. And then 2 more inches, or one more standard deviation, would be 6'2". And going the other way from 5'10", a standard deviation of 2 away means we'd be 5'8", and down here be at 5'6". So then what we can say is all these values that are 2 standard deviations above and 2 standard deviations below represent usually about 95% of the population. So 2 standard deviations usually gives us our usual values for that population. Sometimes you might hear somebody say the range rule of thumb, and that just says that the range is about 4 times the standard deviation. So if you knew the standard deviation, you could take that times 4, and that would give you, you see how we have 4 standard deviations there, it kind of does that. You can approximate the standard deviation, if you know the range, by dividing by 4, but that's not a very accurate way to do things, but sometimes you might see that in there. And finally, variation is just the square of the standard deviation. So if you know your standard deviation, you take it to the second power, you get your variance. If you know the variance, you take the square root of that, and you get the standard deviation. The symbol for sample is the S, so for variance sample, it's S squared, and for the standard deviation for a population was sigma, so we take sigma squared to get the variation for the variance for the population, sorry. And the sample variance S squared is an unbiased estimator of the population variance, which means that values of the sample standard deviation tend to target the value of the population standard deviation instead of under or overestimating it. So we say that it's a nice unbiased estimator. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.